Get ready to match the stars. Charlie Hale, Brett Summers, Richard Deacon, Joanne Crew, Richard Dawson, and Patty Doyle as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the star of Match Game 74, Gene Rivers.
Thank you, John Ellison, and your friends at Gentle Hearts.
I think you're getting a little too chic.
Too chic? No, yes. The really good-looking one is the dingbat over here.
Let me explain this.
I'll explain it.
There's a couple of bill collectors in the house. Just say something about sorry Richard isn't here today.
Yeah, it's too bad that Richard Dawson couldn't make it today, however.
Oh, there they go. Phew, that was close.
Hey, little rascals.
Out there at your assembly, say hello to our two players, Jerry Chiavetta and Major Goolsby. How are you today?
Very good.
Jerry's a current champ. She's won $2,850. She's being challenged by the Major here. We finished the game yesterday and ended in a dead heat, or a tie, as we say. In the game show business. So today we have to go to a tiebreaker, which I will reveal to you now. Yes, I'm going to reveal the tiebreaker now because I want to reveal it now.
Oh,
there it is.
You broke the tie.
Those are the two questions. No, we didn't break the tie yet.
Won't you have a commercial first?
Yeah, we'll have a commercial right. First, and then we'll these two questions and one question each, and the one who's done the most, that'll be it.
So see, smooth. Bing.
There it is. Go.
Like oil.
See, now we go to the tiebreaker. Now, Major, would you make a selection, A or B?
A, Jim.
A. Mm-hmm. One question for each. The one who scored the most... shall we wipe the slate clean there? Thank you. Aww. The one who scores the
neat.
Most will be the
yes,
winner.
Yes, you have to be neat.
Yes, everything has to be... Zsa Zsa said to the hold-up man...
Oh, dialect.
Who does Zsa Zsa?
I do Percy Kilbride.
Oh, darling,
look, darling, I don't have any jewels with me, darling, but... If you let me go, I'll give you one of my blanks. Look, darling, I don't have any jewels with me. I don't have any jewels with me, darling. But if you let me go, I'll give you one of my blanks.
One of...
Look, darling, I don't have any jewels with me, darling. But if you let me go, I'll give you one of my blanks.
Oh, I've got it.
Oh, yes. Terrific. Oh,
I've got a terrific answer.
Oh, I'm got an
sorry
answer
I'm not playing.
You.
Really? Oh. I'll write an answer down. Yeah, may
here,
I borrow your
here.
Pen? Thank you.
I'll write it here.
I'll write it right there. This is my answer. Would you hold a card still so
sure,
I can write things?
My pleasure.
With me.
She doesn't have one of those with her.
That's a good answer.
Yes.
Let's save that. We'll show it later.
No.
All right. We're all set over there.
I'm
put it there.
Strict.
All right, now Major Goolsby. Zsa Zsa said to the hold-up man, look, I don't have many jewels with me, darling, but if you let me go, I'll give you one of my...
Kisses.
Kisses.
That is sad.
No. Okay. He, according to the audience, he has given a thumbs-down answer of kisses. Let's find out if he's right or wrong, if the audience is right or wrong. Charlie, what did you say?
Well, I said that you would give him something that she has plenty of. That would be husbands.
One of my husbands, darling. Okay, Brett.
Oh, Major, I'm so sorry, darling. I said that she would give her one of his sisters.
One of his sisters. I thought that was a good answer.
That's very good.
Yes. Uh-huh. What did you say, Richard?
When I panic, I always turn to hair. I said wigs.
One of my wigs. I don't have any jewels with me, darling, but if you let me go, I'll give you one of my blanks. And Major said kisses. And you, my dear?
Well, I said something that gives a lot of kisses. One of her losses.
She has losses?
Opso. Those are dogs.
Yes, I know. Lassa opso.
That's a horse.
That's a very inside answer there. Uh-huh. Okay.
Well,
now, Richard
you
Dawson.
You come up and guess.
Yeah.
She's got you there. This is what...
I said...
Probably the... I say this in sincerity. Probably the greatest host in television.
Not probably.
That's a definite statement.
but certainly one of the worst answer givers. This clown said sisters.
Sisters is a good answer.
Naturally, I said kisses, and that's correct.
There you go, Major. You got one.
Sisters is a terrific
answer. She doesn't carry sisters around with her.
Yeah, she's got them with her all the time. They hang on her take coattails out of there.
Let's send him back to England, sweetheart.
Shall we do that? Deport this fellow. What did you say?
I didn't say kisses or sisters.
What did you say?
I bet you didn't.
I said goulashes.
What are my goulashes? Well,
I don't know.
Thanks for saving me. All right, Major, you didn't do too well with that. You've got one. Now, you need one to tie, two to win. Jerry, you're in a good spot here. Let's see how it works. The captain of the ship said, I have good news and bad news. The good news is that all the booze you can drink is on the house. The bad news is that we're blank. The bad news is that we're blank.
Yeah, we heard that part.
No, I want the first
let's
part.
Let's do that one over again.
All right.
Wow.
Captain of the ship said, I've got good news and bad news. The good news is that all the booze you can drink is on the house. The bad news is that we're blank. The bad news is that we are blank.
I don't like the way you say that.
Let me just see what you've done here.
Very good, very good.
Terrific answer.
Yes, I thought so.
You got a terrific answer?
Probably.
The captain.
Yeah, you got a terrific answer.
The captain said what, sweetheart?
The captain said, the bad news is that we're blank.
What was the first one?
Come on, see, they're in this boat, you see, and they always forget.
I get all.
Got 1,000 people on the boat.
1,000 people on the boat. The bad news is we're blank.
Yeah.
She still didn't understand it.
Is everybody waiting for a little me?
Yes, Brett.
Yes. I'm all ready.
Always.
All right. Here we go. Jerry Chiavetta, the captain of the ship, said, I have good news and bad news. The good news is that all the booze you can drink is on the house. The bad news is that we're...
A ship.
We're what?
A ship.
A ship. We've been on a little over a year. That may be the worst answer we've had in the history of the show. See, I said it's the captain, and the implication is that he is on a ship because I said captain.
You leave that girl alone.
I didn't even touch her. All right, we'll find out right now. She said, the bad news is that we're a ship.
She said that.
She said that.
You know, if I matched her, I would have myself committed.
Yes.
What did you say? I said the bad news is that we're sinking.
That's right. See, the first sentence was...
She meant a ground, right, or something? A ground, a ship.
Is that what you meant?
A ship?
A vast, ahoy.
Well, he said the drinks were on the house, and they're
you
not on a house.
House and ship.
Oh, house and ship. But I said the captain of the ship's... Well, all right. Brett, what did you say?
You're going to love my answer.
Am I?
If you like her answer, you're just going to be crazy about it.
The bad news is that we're...
We're in a castle.
Ah! Okay, Richard.
How many years have you been on? And that's the worst answer you ever got?
That's right.
Well, it's the worst question I've ever heard. But an answer to it, I gave a pretty bad answer, too.
Pretty bad. Well, it's for old Richard Deacon.
Terrible.
He's
terrible
out
question,
of it.
Terrible answer.
Okay, the answer Jerry Chiavetta is looking for is a ship. The bad news is that we're a ship. What did you say?
No. I gave a good answer. I said that we are sinking.
Sinking is the answer, right, audience? Okay. Got two more chances to get a ship there. Richard?
Sinking, though.
Sinking. Patty Deutsch has a very pensive look on her face.
She do, don't she?
She do.
Yes, I said the bad news is that we're out of ice.
Stand by for a moment or so here. Jerry, you're going to leave here with a pretty good bundle of money.
I can't complain at all.
One game you won, and you did very well with that. $2,850. Pleasure to meet you.
Thank you.
Jerry Chiavetta. Goodbye. You got to stand by here for a moment or so while we're getting all set for the Big Money Supermatch. You ready?
Yes, I am.
All right. We'll get to that right after we get to this message. Here we are with Major Goolsby. This is his first time up here.
for the big money super match, and he's got his $100. Now he's going to try for over $5,000. You're happy about being here, right?
That's right, Gene.
Okay, Major. We're ready to go, and this is the way it goes, Major. We polled the recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Fortune blank. Now, the answer they gave most often is worth $500. You got to match it, though. Then if you match the next one, you get $250. And the third, $100. Which celebrities do you want a little assist from?
Richard.
Fortune.
Something I call Gene when we're alone. Cookie.
Fortune cookie.
He loves that.
Yes. Another one?
Brett.
What Jack married me for, because he was a fortune hunter.
Fortune hunter.
And he married came up empty money, handed, I might add.
And he what?
Came up empty handed.
Came up empty handed. One more, Major.
Charlie.
Charlie Brill.
Fortune teller.
Fortune teller. Now you got three, Major. You got fortune teller, fortune hunter, fortune cookie. You want one of those, or you want to give us one of your own?
I said fortune cookie.
Mezza, mezza, they say. Maybe yes, maybe no. We're going to find out right now. That's Richard's answer. Fortune cookie is the one we're looking for. Is it up there? If so, where is it? First, may we see the $100 response? Fortune Hunter, that's the one that Brett gave you, right? Okay.
That's true.
Still looking for Fortune Cookie. Here is the $250 response. Fortune Cookie, congratulations, you got it. Okay. What do you think's up there?
Fortune Teller. Teller.
You think Fortune Teller's up there?
Yeah.
You agree with him?
Yeah.
Okay. Fortunate. May we see it if you please. Fortune Teller it is. All right. So that means you're going to play for $2,500, Major. Which one celebrity do you think you can match in order to collect that?
I have to go with Richard.
You had to go to Richard. Okay, Richard, get ready.
Because I gave him that kiss earlier.
That's right. Your kiss helped out a lot. All right, here we go. $2,500 question. Good blank. Good blank. G-O-O-D. He's finished. Now, Major, we call on you and ask you to give us an answer which you think will match his. What do you say? Good
times.
Good times. Yeah. All right. He says good times, a popular CBS TV hit. We've had Jimmy Walker on the show quite a bit. He's on good times, isn't he? Richard, for $2,500, may we see your answer?
That's the person you should have matched it with, Jimmy Walker.
He's not here, though.
I know.
You're the one.
I wrote day. Good
you
day.
Said good day. You know what I thought of good morning?
Did
you?
Goodbye.
Goodbye.
Goodbye. Goodbye.
Okay.
Good evening.
Good Shabbos.
Good news. Good Shabbos.
I never get juicy.
All right.
Good Shabbos.
Now, listen, Major, you got $350 total, and you're going to play another game right now. You ready? Then let's welcome Darla Hager. Hi there. Okay, I guess it's stopped. Darla, you know Major Goolsbee. Now, Darla, would you please tell us a little bit about yourself?
Oh, I have a wonderful husband and a beautiful little two-year-old named Jennifer. And I'm a dental hygiene student at Pasadena City College.
You have pretty teeth.
Thank you.
How do I know?
Oh, they look pretty good.
Pretty good? I deplaqued them this morning.
Very well.
I do that every day. Do you?
Yes, I do.
Good. See?
About five patients a day.
You have five patients a day. All right. You ready, Darla?
Yes.
Here we go. Bing. Make a selection.
B.
B. Everybody plays new game. Dr. Welby said, my last patient had an unusual injury. It's the first time I ever had to put someone's blank in a cast.
An unusual injury?
Most unusual. First time I ever had to put someone's blank in a cast.
Was it a male or a female patient?
I don't know. Dr. Welby hasn't come down from surgery yet, so we don't know if it's a male or a female. Dr. Welby said my last patient had an unusual injury. It's the first time I ever had to put someone's blank in a cast. Ready, ready, ready. Ready, ready.
Breathing.
You really have been breathing, yes. Richard, you're fiddling around, you're ready. Okay, Darla Hager. Dr. Welby said my last patient had a most unusual injury. It's the first time I ever had to put someone's blank in a cast.
Heart.
Heart. Okay, she said heart.
And he had a broken heart.
He had a broken heart, right. Yes. Charlie?
He also had a broken tookie. If you could put it in a cast, I don't know.
Okay. Brett, what do you say?
I say I did not have all the facts, and I had to draw my own conclusions as to the sex of this patient. And I decided that it was a lady patient, and he had to put her bust in a cast.
Okay, that's your answer. Richard?
I'm busted with it.
I'm busted, too.
You did. Okay. So that's two we've got. We've got a pair. All right. You make it three, my dear.
Oh, how rude.
Maybe
three. Make it three, and she can join the circus.
All right, folks, step right up and see that. No, you can... You don't want to show it?
Well, no.
Oh, all right.
Well, you said it was his first time they'd ever done this. And
yes,
the only
right.
thing I can think that you wouldn't put in a cast that they don't put in a cast when it's
oh,
broken.
Oh, get on with it.
Leave that girl alone.
I have to shave again.
His nose.
That's a good answer.
Well, I thought it was a very
sure,
unusual
very good.
Answer.
Unusual answer.
When you have your nose fixed, they put it in plaster, don't they?
No, they don't put it in a cast. They just put a little Band-Aid there. They
Do
set
they?
It and they put a hunk of tape there
How
and
do you
that's
know?
It. I've seen it many times. Football players have a hunk of tape there all the time.
Well, I think that's just to write telephone numbers down on.
No. Well, they write plays there. 27, fighter 2, hike on 3. Okay. What do you say?
Well, this patient went skating for
skating?
The first time.
Yes.
Had to put his derriere in a
his
cast.
His derriere. Most unusual injury is the first time I ever had to put someone's blank in a cast, and the answer we're looking for is heart.
You're not going to find it here.
No.
I said his bottom.
His bottom. I guess that scored more than any of the others. Major, your question will come up in a moment or so, but right now we've got to stop and take a look at this. Now, here we go with the Major's first-round question, and it is a little limerick. Are you ready for a little limerick?
No. Oh,
you love limericks, don't you? Say yes, of course.
Yep.
Farmer Brown's hair was all graying because his flock of old geese were not laying. His horse ate his hat, but still worse than that, his wife in the barnyard was blanking.
From that day,
You don't understand. You don't understand the question. I'll let you read it. Charlie, come on, you can read the question yourself. You have a nice voice. Read the question.
Here is a limerick. Father Brown's hair was all graying because his flock of old geese were not laying. His horse ate his hat, but still worse than that, his wife in the barnyard was
blanking. So you got the idea now, Jenny?
No. I got it.
You know how limericks rhyme?
Yes, but I...
Yeah, I got it.
Graying, laying, hat, that, blanking.
I think we should say we like some limericks.
You like some limericks,
obviously,
but not this
not that one.
Right. Well, like it or not, that's it, folks.
I've done it.
You've done it?
Nasty with me.
Rhymes with that.
That's the only thing I can think of.
All right.
I want to see beat the clock.
Nothing wrong with that.
Well,
yeah,
nothing's
already.
Wrong with anything, really.
Here we go. Now, Major, Farmer Brown's hair was all graying because his flock of old geese were not laying. His horse ate his hat, but still worse than that, his wife in the barnyard was...
Neighing.
Neighing! That's a good one. Yeah, his wife in the barnyard was neighing. He came up with a good answer, dummies. Let me see yours now.
Very good.
First. Dummy Charlie is first.
Yes, that's true. I am. Well, see, it may be a neighbor to neighing. I put down braying.
Braying.
That's the same.
Yeah. Well, that's good.
Yeah.
That's a good.
Thank you.
Okay. Scratch out the fact that I call him a dummy. Okay.
Thank you so much.
Dummy number two. Are you a dummy or not?
Well, there were some Marines in the neighborhood.
Yeah.
And his wife was playing.
I see. Okay. All right. Since you've got the idea of the limerick, it rhymes. Richard?
Playing.
playing. Did you get the idea of the rhyme?
No, not at all. I only think I could think that was rhyming was praying.
Praying ain't a bad answer. Is that bad? No. He's looking for neighing. No one's matched
it's
him yet.
It's a religious break.
Yes, it was. What did you say, Richard?
Oh, I've got a dizzy spell coming.
You don't want to show your answer, do you? You're stalling because you got a rotten answer, haven't you, Richard?
Is neighing rotten?
Neighing is terrific!
Aren't you ashamed?
I'm ashamed of myself. I'm ashamed of myself for doubting
you. I just let you walk right into that, didn't I?
That's right. What did you say?
Nothing terribly
bright. Okay, nothing terribly bright.
No, I said praying.
Praying, okay. Neighing it is, so at the end of round one, it is, you have nothing, right? It's 1-0, favor the current champ, and we got to stop right here, and don't go away, though, because we got more of this. Come right back. That's it, celebrities. Got to quit here and now, and we'll pick up with round two with our two players over there next time. Thank you all. You were just splendid. Join us next time for Match Game 74. Gene Rayburn here. Goodbye.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74, a Mark Goodson, Bill Sodman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of these CBS stations.